Hi, I'm Erin Cottrell, and you're on My Runway Shoot.
Okay, Erin, Miss New Jersey.
I wish I was Miss New Jersey, but from New Jersey, yeah.
When did you move out here?
2002.
Okay, and why?
For work, really. I was acting in New York and started screen testing in LA more and more, and I just thought I should move here and live here.
So they say that New York is mostly theater, mm-hmm. LA is more pilots, film. Does that still ring true?
I think so, yeah, definitely. I started in theater in New York and then started to do soap operas. So I was on All My Children and Guiding Light, and I was like, oh, I guess I'm not gonna be a musical theater actor, I guess I'm gonna do this now.
Well, I want everyone to get to know you a little bit better. You just told me that you're a new mom.
I am a new mom. I have a 3-month-old little girl at home.
What's her name?
Her name is Donovan.
Okay.
But we call her Nova for short.
That's pretty. What is that after?
Well, Donovan is actually my mother's maiden name.
Okay.
And Nova is in the center of Donovan, so we just picked that.
Okay, perfect. And you met your husband out here.
I did.
He's also from New Jersey.
He is also from New Jersey, yes.
Can we say like Joy-Z?
He's totally Joy-Z. But he was like North Jersey and I was South Jersey, like closer to Philly. So we had like, we don't really have accents, I don't think. But yeah, we're like from New York and Philly. It's like a totally different vibe.
When was the moment that you knew you were in love with him?
That's a great question. Well, he was in a sketch comedy show when I first started dating him, and he was by far the funniest person in there, and I was like, dude, you can make me laugh for the rest of my life. That's all I need.
You know, my mom always says that because she's like, when I met your dad, he was thin and cool. Now he's fat, a little uncool, but he makes me laugh every day of my life.
That's it. We've been together for almost 11 years now, and that's the secret, I think, to our relationship.
That is so great.
Thanks.
Okay, Erin, anytime you're in a film and you have a big name like Elvis Presley, there's going to be a lot of press, a lot of buzz surrounding it. Mm-hmm. So tell me about The Identical.
Okay, so The Identical, which by the way, can't really say Elvis Presley. It's not Elvis necessarily, but he is like the biggest rock star in the world. And essentially, Elvis in general, he in real life had a identical twin brother that he was born with. Our story is essentially, what if that baby didn't die, but that child was given away to a family that could raise him better because it was the Depression and the original family wasn't financially that stable. So what happens to that other child who has the same gift for music and the same drive, but is being told that he needs to be part of the church because his adoptive family is a Baptist minister and his wife, played by Ray Liotta and Ashley Judd. So how I fit in it, I'm actually the narrator of the entire film, and I am the girlfriend and then wife of the identical, the twin that grows up watching all of these things happen. So it's an interesting journey. We go from the 30s into the 70s, and the movie changes film stock as it goes decade to decade. So it'll be sepia, black and white, and then into 50s Technicolor.
Cool.
So we shift. Our director of photography did Chronicles of Narnia and Independence Day.
Wow.
Yeah, and our Karen Wagner, who did our costumes, did The Notebook and The Green Mile. So it's a beautiful look as it goes from decade to decade.
Seems like a lot of thought was put into each part of this.
Yeah, stylistically it's beautiful, and it's all brand new music too, not only sung by the identical, who is kind of the Elvis character, but Darcy and Moe, like a Motown throwback, and like some really fun, just this new stuff, and they've been touring around the country with all the music before the movie comes out. So
wow.
Yeah, it's a funky thing.
What was it like being on that set? I mean, Ray Liotta, is he from Jersey?
He is. Well, Seth Green, myself, and Ray are all from like this Jersey, Philadelphia kind of area. So okay. We all had a kinship there. That was nice. I think friends of mine from high school went to camp with Seth. Like, they were little, like that. So there's like a kinship there that was nice. We had like the same language, but yeah.
You know when you walk into a set and sometimes you just feel like we have something here?
Yeah.
Did you have that?
Yeah. The first time I read the script, the first 10 pages, I was like, oh, this is brilliant. And I was so, so happy to be a part of it. And then when we were on set, the Marcellino family who produced it, their music producers, they're responsible for the Jackson 5 and Bobby Darin and Diana Ross, all these amazing musical artists, they produced this film and they are such an amazing family. It was Dustin Marcellino, the director, Yochanan Marcellino was the executive producer, that's his dad. Jerry Marcellino, the grandfather, was music supervising. So the family just embraced everybody. We went to their home in the middle of Tennessee and made pizza and it was just this like embracing music family. And there was such love during the entire process that I didn't want to leave Tennessee when we were done.
Yeah. It's like a rude awakening coming back to LA with the smog.
It was a little bit upsetting, and Nashville is like the greatest city too, so I was so happy to be there.
Cool. Yeah. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.